Hello, welcome to you all in our channel Banking Preparation. Today's video is all about the Bank and Financial Institution Act 2073, and under this act we'll see the chapter 3, which is related to the transaction of securities. This video is very much useful for the Nepal Bank Limited, Rashtriya Banija Bank Limited, Agriculture Development Bank Limited, and for the Nepal Rashtriya Bank Limited. And if you want to see the first part and second part of this video, the link is given in the description box below and you can check our channel. Now let's start the video. Provisions relating to transaction of securities. According to Chapter 3, Section 8 of Bank and Financial Institution Act 2017, the provisions concerning transaction of securities are about the prospectus shall be as follows. All the bank and financial institution must submit their prospectus to Nepal Rashtra Bank before issuing share capital. Similarly, until and unless such prospectus is registered, the bank and financial institution or anyone on behalf of the bank and financial institution shall not be allowed to publish the prospectus of such a bank or financial institution. According to Chapter 3, Section 9 of Bank and Financial Institution Act 2017, allotment of shares shall be as follows. The bank and financial institution should have to set aside of share minimum 30% for the general public, minimum 51% for promoters, and maximum of 0.5% for employees. Similarly, according to Chapter 3, Section 10 of Bank and Financial Institution Act, transaction of securities shall be as follows. A bank or financial institution shall submit a copy of an agreement entered into by it on the transaction of securities through any institution dealing with the securities before the Nepal Rashtra Bank within 7 days from the date of the conclusion of such agreement. At the same time, a bank or financial institution shall, while issuing any type of debenture or financial instruments, obtain prior approval from the Nepal Rashtra Bank. Meanwhile, according to Chapter 3, Section 11 of Bank and Financial Institution Act, provisions relating to the sales of shares or pledging of securities shall be as follows. A promoter of a bank or financial institution shall not be entitled to sell or place any share register under his or her ownership for at least 5 years from the date of commencement of financial transaction. Likewise, lock-up period for converting promoter share into public is defined as 10 years. Similarly, lock-up period for the transaction of promoter share is defined as 5 years, and to make a transaction of promoter share who holds more than 2% share capital of bank and financial institution must get prior approval from Nepal Rashtra Bank. At the same time, according to Chapter 3, Section 13 of Bank and Financial Institution Act, prohibition on buyback by bank or financial institution of its own shares shall be as follows. Bank and financial institution can buy back their share if they fulfill the conditions which are outlined by law are given below. First one, if the shares issued by the bank or financial institution have already been fully paid up. Likewise, if the shares issued by the bank or financial institution have already been listed in the securities market. Similarly, if the buyback of its own share is authorized by the Article of Association of the concerned bank or financial institutions, if a special resolution has been passed at the general meeting of the concerned bank or financial institution authorizing the buyback of its own share. At last, if the ratio of the debt owned by the bank or financial institution is not more than double of the capital and general reserve fund after such buyback of share. So these all are the conditions for buyback of share by bank and financial institution. And thank you for watching our video. This much for today's video, and if you like our video, please do like. Do not forget to subscribe our channel and share this video. For more, please visit our channel. Thank you.